2 Timothy chapter 1 verses 6 through 18. Remain faithful. In this passage, Paul will list things that Timothy should remain faithful to as a way of living out the faith that is within him. The work of the gospel was challenging in itself, but made more difficult in the early years because of the attacks they had to endure from the Jewish leaders who wanted to destroy the faith and those who promote it. Now, however, it was the Roman government that was announcing the Christian religion and about to execute Paul as one of its prominent leaders. This turn of events sent a chill through the Christian churches in the Roman Empire and put on notice its high-profile leaders, including the apostles and ministers like Timothy, Mark, and Titus. Despite those threats, however, now was not the time to shrink back or keep a low profile. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. It is the Holy Spirit who equips every Christian with three things that enable a believer to face any kind of obstacle or attack. Power, not just courage or bravery, but the power to hold on, to endure, to suffer, and even die without giving up faith or the hope of heaven. Love. Difficulties and suffering cannot change or destroy the attitude of love in a Christian heart, constantly renewed and enabled by the Spirit of God. Sound mind. Christians don't lose their minds or their bearing in times of trouble. The Spirit of God and His Word steady the mind and heart of the believer in both good and bad times. Paul is reminding Timothy of the spiritual resources that he has in Christ that will enable him to stay true to his calling as an evangelist. Therefore, do not be ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but share with me in the sufferings for the gospel according to the power of God, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus before time began, but has now been revealed by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, to which I was appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles. For this reason I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. Paul reviews the two main blessings of the gospel, verses 9 and 10. First, salvation by grace and not works. And second, the promise of eternal life. At the beginning, Christians could preach the gospel in the open, but now to do so will become risky. The choice was to preach the gospel and risk arrest and possibly death, or to be quiet and avoid trouble. Paul doesn't want Timothy to shy away from the message of the gospel or the proclaiming of it either. He wants the young preacher to be able to suffer on account of the gospel, trusting that God is aware of the possibly negative circumstances that may arise in doing this, and assuring that he is able to fulfill all of his promises despite the adversities. Hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus. That good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Spirit who dwells in us. Again, Paul refers to the Holy Spirit as the one who will enable Timothy to maintain the purity of the message and manner it is to be proclaimed. As a normal sinful human being, Timothy could not do this, but with the Holy Spirit to guide and inspire him, Timothy will be able to keep this charge. Paul, as an apostle, had among other gifts the spiritual gift of inspiration. What he wrote was inspired by God. Timothy, on the other hand, was not inspired, and we don't have any of his writings. However, what Paul says about him suggests that he may have been gifted with spiritual knowledge and or wisdom, which made him a valuable worker and teacher to assist Paul. This may explain more clearly Paul's encouragement to guard through the Holy Spirit the store of knowledge and teachings about the gospel that Timothy possessed. This you know, that all those in Asia have turned away from me, among whom are Phygellus and Hermogenes. The Lord grant mercy to the household of Onesiphorus, for he often refreshed me and was not ashamed of my chain. But when he arrived in Rome, he sought me out very zealously and found me. The Lord grant to him that he may find mercy from the Lord in that day. And you know very well how many ways he ministered to me at Ephesus. Paul breaks his line of thought concerning various instructions and encouragements by citing two examples. First, Phygellus and Hermogenes. Paul likely tried to encourage various leaders from the churches in Asia Minor to come to his trial and testify on his behalf. However, none from these churches agreed, including the two men he names, who probably were at the church in Ephesus where Timothy was preaching. They represent those who were unwilling to take a risk for their faith. This episode exposed the weakness of their faith and is also a warning to Timothy about them. And second, Onesiphorus. Unlike the other two, this man was not ashamed of Paul's imprisonment. In other words, the apostle's imprisonment did not weaken or destroy this brother's faith. It seems that he also was a faithful and fruitful member of the church at Ephesus. Paul pronounces a blessing on this man, that he received mercy from the Lord in the way that he showed mercy on Paul. Remain faithful. And so, Paul encouraged Timothy to remain faithful to his calling as an evangelist, faithful to the gospel message, and faithful to the content and manner of teaching, giving and modeled for him by Paul himself. He then reminds Timothy of men who by their actions demonstrated clear examples of what faithful and unfaithful Christians act like in real time. This is all for now. I hope you join us in our next video, where Paul will encourage Timothy to remain faithful to his ministry and will provide four practical examples of those who succeeded in their various areas of service. Thank you for your time. May God richly bless you.